Welcome to the Inverse Problems channel.
I am Fernando Moura.
And I'm Rashmi Murthy.
Let's start this course studying a simple example. In these and the next videos, we will present you many aspects of the theory behind electrical impedance tomography, or EIT, by exploring simple examples.
Simple examples will facilitate the understanding of the subject. They will serve as the foundation for understanding EIT theory.
With a solid understanding of the simple problems, you have conditions to follow the next series of videos where we will explore EIT in more details.
Let's jump into it. Let's start with a single resistor. We attach wires to the resistor, we push 1 milliamp of current through it and measure the voltage across the resistor. Then the question is, can we find the value of the resistance?
Yes, we can. We just have to use Ohm's law. Ohm's law states that the voltage we measure will be equal to the product between the resistance and the current. In this example, R will be then the tension, the voltage divided by the current, which is 5000 ohms. This example was very easy.
What if the situation is a bit more complicated? For example, we may have two resistors connected in series. Let's try to find the values of R1 and R2 based on the measurements taken at the extremities.
From the association of resistors, we can clearly see that the sum of the voltage drops across the resistors must be equal to the total voltage drop, 5 volts. Now, using Ohm's law of each resistor in this equation results in R1 plus R2 equal 5000 ohms. But this expression is just relates the total resistance of the association, R1 plus R2, with the measurements. We could have R1 equal 4 kilo ohms and R2 equal 1 kilo ohm, or we might have, for instance, R1 equal 3 kilo ohms and R2 equal 2 kilo ohms. Both of the situation will fit our measurement. So which solution is the correct? This problem does not have an unique solution. You will quickly see that there are many, many ways of choosing R1 and R2 that will result in a total of 5 kilo ohms. In this example, all the solutions that match our measurements lie along this line segment. The true solution is a single point along this line segment.
As long as R1 and R2 sum up to 5 kilo ohms, they match our measurements. They are all equally valid solutions based only on the available measurements. This is a key aspect of inverse problems. Sometimes the measurement we have is not enough to uniquely identify the solution of the problem.
Someone could argue that the challenge in this example is that we have two resistors. The next example will show you that the number of resistors is associated, but it's not the core issue.
Consider the same association of resistors. We know that this problem doesn't have a unique solution based on the voltage drop across its extremities. Let's bring the resistors closer. It's not difficult to see that the measurement will be the same since the same amount of wire and resistor lie between the measurement points. In other words, although the amount of wire in the central part is reducing, we are compensating this reduction by increasing the amount on the sides of the resistors.
Now move them so close that the resistors touch, forming a single resistor R with compound interior, red and blue. Since we did not remove or add any new material to the association, we know that the measurement must be the same, 5 volts. Now we have a single resistor and we can find R. Using Ohm's law in this resistor, we find that the resistance is 5 kilo ohms. But wait a minute. Did you just find the single solution to the problem that previously had many solutions?
Not really. At first, it seems we have solved the problem. However, note that the resistor value we just found is in fact the total resistance of the previous example. This question was also answered in the previous example when we found that R1 plus R2 is 5 kilo ohms. The equivalent question we should ask after joining the two resistors is, what are the resistances of the colored halves? This question will lead to a similar result. We will find that our measurement cannot uniquely determine the solution. The number of unknowns did not change between the examples, it's just that the question changed.
In this last example, we have n resistors connected in series inside a box. We don't know how many resistors are connected. Could be 1, 2, 3, or any number. We only have the two terminals available for measuring. So what can we say about the values of the resistors inside the box? This is an extreme case. We don't even know the number of resistors that are inside the box. Because of the lack of information, all we can say is that the total resistance inside the box is 5 kilo ohms. Depending on the number of resistors connected in series, we'll have different expressions. We don't know which one is correct. If you have one resistor, then R1 is equal 5 kilo ohms. If you have two resistors, then R1 plus R2 is 5 kilo ohms. If you have three resistors, we have R1 plus R2 plus R3 equal 5 kilo ohms, and so on.
The situation is even more complicated if we don't know how the resistors are connected inside the box. Here we have all possible arrangements using three resistors. We can have all of them in series, or all of them in parallel, or some of them in parallel and some of them in series. Current will flow differently depending on whether the resistors are connected in series or in parallel. As a result, the equation that relates the voltages with the resistances will be different in each case.
When two resistors are in series, the total resistance of the association is the sum of the resistance R1 and R2. When two resistors are in parallel, the total resistance of the association is the inverse of the sum of the inverses of the two resistances. With three resistors, we have a mixture of the two cases. In this case, we first associate in parallel R2 and R3, and the result of that we associate in series with R1. And in this next case, we first associate R3 and R2 in series, and the result of that we associate in parallel with R1. In conclusion, for each internal arrangement of the three resistors, we'll have a different equation connecting voltages with resistors. We can clearly see that the problem becomes challenging very quickly, even with a small number of resistors.
If we want to find the values of the internal resistors inside a box without opening it, we also need to find the number of resistors inside the box and how the resistors are connected inside the box. In summary, if we want to know what the values of the internal resistances are, we need to know something about the internal arrangement. Otherwise, all we can say is that the net effect that we call equivalent resistance of the association. This last example is very similar to the type of problem that EIT is trying to solve. We want to know the internal resistances inside a box based on measurements taken on its boundary.
In other words, we want to see what's inside the box but without opening it.
Thank you for watching.
The journey of EIT will continue in the next video.